In his book, Fuzzy Memories, Jack Handy talks about dealing with a school bully. And like so many bullies in so many schools, they're not that creative. He demanded Jack's lunch money every day. And finally, Jack just got tired of it. He decided he was going to do something about it. He was tired of being hungry. He was tired of losing in this confrontation. And he was going to take matters into his own hands. And that's what we're going to talk about today on The Encouraging Word. So Jack decides he is sick and tired of giving this bully his lunch money, going hungry, and being humiliated in the process. So he goes, taking matters into his own hands, to a karate teacher. He decides, I'm going to give that guy the chop chop, and this is going to be over. And so he does. And he goes and takes the first lesson, and that lesson's free. And then the teacher tells him, now the rest of the lessons, those are going to be $5 each. Jack does the math, and he looks at his money, and he goes, man, I think it's going to be cheaper to pay the bully. And so he goes back to paying the bully. But he regrets it later because he spent all that time hungry and humiliated. We make the same mistake sometimes. When we decide we're going to take matters into our own hands and we're going to confront Satan head on, we're going to follow Christ, and we're going to live a life strengthened by God and strengthened by His Spirit, and we start to take those matters into our hands and God's, and then God says, okay, so there's some things I'm going to need you to get rid of, and some new habits that you're going to have to develop. I want you to spend some time in prayer. I want to hear from you every day. I want to speak to you through my word. And so, you know, that means that we're going to have to spend some time. It may just be $5, so karate lesson, 5 minutes in prayer, 5 minutes in the word. But we go, that's a new habit. And before we know it, we're back to paying the bully. We decided it's easier just to take the path of least resistance. But let me ask you something. What is the ultimate cost of paying the bully? Humiliation, loss, and hunger. The cost of following Christ. There is a real one. There is a cost to discipleship. We have to submit ourselves to the Lord's will and to His leading. But in all of that training, which is a lot of what God is trying to do through that time in prayer, time in the Word, and time with our brothers and sisters in Christ in church, all of that training is just like the karate. Jack would have been so much better off if he had gone ahead and paid those $5 and got some skills and stood up to the bully once and for all. We would too. How much better would our marriages be? How much better would our workplace be? How much better would we feel confronting the man or the woman in the mirror if we just pay that small price to let God train us in spiritual warfare so we can stand up to the bully? How much better off would we be? I want you to think about that tonight as you spend some time, those 5 minutes, in prayer with God. Maybe ask Him, God, how much better could I be if I just really gave this all over to You and started saying no to the bully? How much better off would I be if I was stronger and more trusting in the strength of the Lord? God bless you as you go to Him with that tonight, and have a great day.